Hello, class of 2020. Mr. Donovan here. I just wanted to take a moment to tell you how proud I am of each and every one of you. When I finally received the recipient list, I couldn't be more proud to see the names that were on there, because each and every one of you represents what a Hatter is, not just in the classroom with some extraordinary, you know, GPAs and test scores, but also in the extracurriculars, from sports to robotics to theater, and then into the community. All the community service hours that this group has put forward is just an amazing thing, and couldn't make me, as the principal of Danbury High School, be more proud. I thank you for all that you've done in Danbury High School for the past 4 years. You will be missed by me and the staff here, and I wish you nothing but the best in your futures. I do want to say a thank you while I have you to, you know, Ms. Basso, Ms. Jacobson, Mr. Miller, the scholarship committee for putting all of this together in a difficult time to try to get it. It took us a little longer than we thought, but I want to thank them for it. And remember, class of 2020, where you had a year that will never be forgotten as a senior class, it is up to you now to go out into the world, whether it's college, work, the military, wherever you plan to go, and make sure that this is the world that you want it to be. I wish you nothing but the best and hope to see you soon. Bye.
Hey, Jordan, it's Coach Thierry. Just want to congratulate you on your scholarship. Just another accolade for you and another great achievement in your high school career. I wish we could celebrate it under different circumstances, but nonetheless, okay, very, very proud of you. You've achieved so much in such a short period of time and shown so much growth the past couple of years. And I think everyone that knows you, you've had a tremendous positive impact in their lives, and we're all excited to see what you're able to achieve at the next level. All right, thanks again, Jordan, for everything that you've done, and we couldn't be more proud of you.
Talia, I want to praise you for your creativity, both artistic and literary. I so look forward to seeing the creative output that you're going to produce in the future, in college and beyond, and your boldness in speaking up in discussion is tremendous. Your voice helped to inspire and galvanize your classmates, to give people a chance to speak up, to share their views, to explore their deeper ideas. And that ability, that strength to energize the marketplace of ideas cannot be overstated. It is of incalculable value. My one regret where you're concerned is that I never won one of the raffle quilts, but perhaps so it goes. Congratulations, Talia, and have a great summer.
Drew, what up? Wanted to say congratulations for winning these awards today. I know that they are well-deserved. Thank you for an awesome 2 years of knowing each other. Thank you for everything that you offered me and ways of teacher improvement, having your voice in class and hearing your insight as to how certain activities felt and helped you understand content of AP Lit, really helped me improve as a teacher as well. And thank you for being such a strong leader in that class and keeping everyone up to pace, giving them a bar to also strive for and achieve as you have. I know that you're going to be wildly successful in whatever area you apply yourself in. So again, thank you, and I hope to hear from you with updates as to how life treats you after high school. See ya.
Hi, Tanya. Congratulations on your award. As I was thinking back about your time at Danbury High School, and in particular in HBSA, I focused in on your project with the pressed flowers. And it really made me think that your journey has been almost analogous to that of the pressed flowers. Their calm beauty brought relief to the people in your studies, much like how you reaching your life goals that you have set for yourself will bring good health to others. When I think about your time at DHS, I remember you as this quiet force, ready to take on amazing challenges. You came to HBSA in the end of your sophomore year like a seed, so full of potential and ready to grow. And now you're moving on to the next chapter of your life as this radiant flower, full of grace and with a will to change the world for the better. Congratulations and good luck as you pursue your dreams.
Hi, Rebecca. Mr. Harris here to wish you congratulations not only on your graduation, but on your scholarship. Well done and well deserved. Since you and I have already spent countless hours talking during this pandemic, I'm going to say a few things to Mom and Dad. Mr. and Mrs. Anderson, I know that you're aware that Rebecca is an awesome student in person, so I wanted to tell you why she's going to be an amazing teacher someday. First, she loves to learn. She loves to embrace new challenges, and she has no fear. Second, I know firsthand she has the ability to reach students. Rebecca volunteered to be a peer tutor in my flex class, and she was a great help to some of our most needy kids. It made her so happy when her students learned and thanked her for her help. She's also been my teacher, helping me learn and helping me set up my Google Classroom during distance learning. Lastly, and most importantly, she's one of the most kind and compassionate people I have ever known. Rebecca and I have had long talks about her teaching career, and I promised her that someday when she's ready, it would be an honor to be her cooperating teacher. Rebecca, this may be the end of high school, but it's just beginning for you about how you're going to affect the lives of your future students. You have what it takes to make an impact, and I couldn't be more excited to follow your journey. God bless you.
Hi, Michael. Congratulations on your award. I am so happy that you decided to pursue a college degree. I think it will serve you well. Never forget all the fun we had in your geometry class. That was a fun group, and I'll miss seeing you around the hallways. Good luck to you, and take care.
I bet you didn't see this one coming, Sarah Barta. I bet you right now you're sitting there saying to yourself, Mr. Bertelli. But Mr. Bertelli and I, you know, sometimes we had little things. Yes, Sarah, we did. And, you know, I think I told you many, many times, whether it was in English class or in yearbook, that failure leads to success. And you are living proof of that. You didn't fail, but we certainly stumbled, right? Our relationship had ups and it had downs. But in the end, you have proven yourself to be someone who I think really understands that really understands that even though sometimes we do things that aren't the smartest, we can learn from them and we can become better than them. I saw a look in your eye a couple of months ago that told me that, and that told me that you are going to be a smashing success, and I trust that that's what's going to happen. You deserve tonight. You deserve the accolades, and I'm excited because you are now turning the corner to the next big piece of your life, and I'm sure you're going to be a success in it. So I just want to wish you all the best of luck, and we will miss you here at Danbury High School.
Hey, Maddie, congratulations on your award and on graduating from high school. It's been such an honor to have you as a student for the past 4 years. And it's going to be really weird not having you in class in the fall to help keep me organized and on task and help keep the other students on task as well. But we'll definitely look forward to having you back on stage with us as a member of the alumni choir. So best of luck. Congratulations. I hope you get a chance to celebrate this accomplishment with friends and family. Congratulations.
Hi, Aiden. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you for reaching this point. I've been, you know, pleased to get to know you for 1 year having you in AP Lang, but it's been so amazing getting to know so much more about you, you sharing your passion for track, all of your thoughts and ideas and creativity in AP Lang. I really saw you work hard and try new things and ask a bunch of questions and stuff that you may not have grappled with before. And I really enjoyed the fact that you trusted me to sit down and work towards applying for colleges. I'm really, really excited for you to go to Stonehill and to get back into training. I know it'll be a wonderful thing for you. And I can't wait to hear what awesome stuff you do. Congratulations again. Bye.
Brady Callahan, congratulations on this award. I'm sure it's the first of many that are going to come your way. From our time together in AP Physics last year, I know that you're a young man who loves to embrace the challenge and just really get after a problem and try to make sense of it. And that's going to serve you really well in college. So I look forward to hearing about all your successes as you move forward. And best of luck at University of Massachusetts Amherst. I know you're going to do great. Congratulations again.
Catherine, in the year that I have had the opportunity to teach you, I find that you have grown into such an amazing young lady, artist, and goal setter. Your confidence as an artist has grown and better keep growing. Don't doubt yourself. You are amazing and hard work has paid off. I know you will be successful in all that you choose to do. Don't forget your days in A310 and the laughs as you grew into an artist that you are. Congratulations on your award, Catherine. You deserve it. Love, Mrs. Newt.
Let's find out who this award is for. K-R-I-S-T-E-N, Kristen Castro. You have brains in your head and feet in your shoes. You could steer yourself in any direction you choose. Congratulations on winning an award. Your caring, compassionate demeanor is just what our future students will need to be successful in a classroom. And I have no doubt that you will be that teacher. I've appreciated all of your help the past 2 years, and I know that you'll come back to visit often and show me pictures of your bulletin boards that you've created for your own classroom. Best of luck, Kristen, on the next adventure. Congratulations, and I can't wait to hear about your own teaching experiences when you graduate from college.
Hey, Andre, Mr. Bach here. Just want to say congratulations on a great high school career. You were a pleasure to have in my Algebra 2 class sophomore year. It has been a while, but it was evident then that you were a dedicated, intelligent student with a tremendous drive with great mathematical ability. You continue your academic success the last 2 years at DHS, finishing in the top 20 of your class. More importantly, you have a great attitude and a unique ability to get along with everyone. You have a great balance of being an awesome student, but better person, and just a really cool kid. Your hard work has set you up for a tremendous future. Best of luck at Northeastern. I know you will continue to be great. Go Huskies.
Hi, Emilio. I am so proud of you, and I wish you all the luck in your future endeavors, whatever you are deciding to do. I feel really blessed to have had you in my classroom, and I'm really enjoyed your perspective and sharing with both me and your colleagues in the classroom, And thank you for letting me be a process of writing your college essay. So I wish you the best of luck. Please keep in touch. Congratulations.
Audrey Clifford, congratulations. You made it. You're at the end. And I am so proud of everything you've accomplished. Not just this year, but throughout your entire high school career. I'm very fortunate and lucky to have had you as a freshman when you came into my classroom as a very inquisitive student. And I've gotten to see you blossom into this articulate, thoughtful, very creative young lady. I think one of the things that strikes me the most about you is you have this deep intellectual curiosity where you're curious about other cultures and what makes people react the way they do and express themselves the way that they do. And I think that that intellectual curiosity is going to serve you very well in life and take you very far. So I am very excited to see and hear about all of the wonderful things that you're going to do in college and beyond. So best of luck to you. Please keep in touch. And I can't wait to hear about everything that happens for you in the future. And to Mr. and Mrs. Clifford, thank you so much for letting me teach your daughter and your daughters. You have three fabulous daughters and you've just done a phenomenal job with all of them. So again, thank you. And Audrey, I know that they are so, so proud of you. So thank you.
Ben, call it Darcy. How you doing? This is Mr. James from sophomore year physics, first thing in the morning. What I remember most about Ben is that even though it was early in the morning, first period physics, he came in and he hit the books hard. He had a mind for math, a mind for physics. And I can see that it's just been developing since you left my classroom, Benjamin. So congratulations to you on graduation. And congratulations on your award. And I'm looking forward to seeing what kind of stuff you learn about and discover in the future in college. Good luck.
Congratulations, Aiden. I just want to take a minute to be able to wish you the best of luck as you move forward in all of your endeavors. I had a great time getting to know you this year, your group of close friends, and I felt very lucky to have all of you in class together, and to be able to, hear your thoughts on different topics, and to be able to read your writings, and to be able to engage on that level. And I know that the future is going to be really bright for you, and that you're going to be able to really achieve all of your goals, no matter what you set your mind to. Again, it was great getting to know you. I wish you the best of luck. Congratulations on winning these awards and scholarships. And I hope all goes well, and all of your dreams and all of your goals come true. All right, bye.
Hi, Macanita. Congratulations. It has been a wonderful experience to be your teacher this year in Honors Pre-Calc. I know that math sometimes makes you muy triste, but you did an amazing job. Thank you for being so awesome. Thanks for sharing your lunchtime with me. Thank you for coming by just to be silly and making me laugh when I needed it, and sometimes to cry, because sometimes that is also necessary. Congratulations again. I hope you have a wonderful summer, and know that I will always be here with purple tissues just for you.
Hey, Connor, just wanted to say congratulations on your award and congratulations on graduating. I'm really proud of the way you've grown over the last few years in our baseball program, not only as a player, but as a young person. I wish you the best of luck moving forward. I'm sorry for the fact that you lost out in your senior season. I can't imagine what that's like, but be proud of the work you did do over the 3 years in our program, and proud of the person that you became, because I know I am. But anyways, good luck. Stay in touch.
Hi, Fernando. Congratulations on your graduation and your awards. I'm so very excited for you. I know you'll do great things, and good luck at Central Connecticut. I know you're going in for physical ed. I know you'll do great because you've worked so hard this throughout the year. You've taken everything seriously, and you focus on only the most important things. I'm going to miss our conversation both in class and in during the flex time. And I'm just so proud to see your accomplishments because you've worked hard for every single one of them. And I know it's not easy to get to places that you want, but through hard work and persistency, I know you will do great. Good luck.
Hey, Larissa, congratulations on your award and congratulations on graduation. I'm so proud of you and everything that you've accomplished. You've always worked really hard in my class, and I've seen you manage a great amount of extracurriculars along with all of your classes, and you've done it so gracefully. And so that's really admirable. I'm really excited to see what UConn brings next year. I can't wait to hear about all of the awesome things that you are doing there. I know you're going to be such a hard worker. I know you're going to put your all into everything. I mean, the John Proctor speech from last year is still one of the most creative speeches that I've heard since I've started that project. So I know that you're going to put your all into everything that you do, and I can't wait to hear about it. Congratulations. You are so deserving of this award, and congratulations on graduation. I'm so proud of you, hon. Bye.
Oh my gosh, Lorena, you're graduating. I can just hear you saying, "Right, Senora?" It's unbelievable, but it's really super cool. You've come so far. I have been so happy to get to know you over the past several years. I have always admired how your love of your family and your passion for social justice and the people around you have really taken center stage in your life. You are an incredible young woman who has a lot to say and will make a big difference in the world. Thank you for being you. Te deseo todo, todo lo mejor y te mando muchas felicitaciones. Congratulations. Te quiero mucho, mucho. Un fuerte abrazo.
Jen, I'm going to miss you. You're leaving this year. I've seen you as this incredible, brave, and driven young woman. You have risen above so many obstacles to be where you are today. I admire your tenacity. You will be more than okay. You will reach for the moon and fall amongst the stars. Best wishes to you as you enter this next chapter. This song, I think, speaks to your journey, and I want you to hear it.
His broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free.
Follow your dreams, Jen.
Congratulations, Kara.
Humorous. Enthusiastic.
Sincere.
Tenacious.
These are all the four words that describe you, Zaira.
Ever since you walked into our rooms freshman year, we knew that you were a force to be reckoned with.
Since then, we've gotten to see you use that enthusiasm all throughout your years in high school.
We will miss you and can't wait to see what you do next.
Congratulations, Gabby.
Congratulations, Gabby. We want to congratulate you for being a recipient of one of Danbury High School's Senior Awards. Gabby, you've been an exceptional student and also a four-year member of the Western Connecticut State University Upward Bound Program. You've amassed over 112 hours of community service in the Danbury area, and we're so proud of you for that. You're always willing to help out anyone in need. And you're always one of the first ones to sign up for community service, I have to say. You're a very kind, compassionate, dedicated student whose kindness just transcends to everyone she meets. You always greet everyone with a smile. I mean, I could be in a have a really bad day, but you would walk in and that smile would just resonate with all of us. You're going to be majoring in pre-nursing at Western, and we wish you the very best as you embark on your lifelong dream of becoming a nurse.
So, Gabby, go out there and change the world, okay?
When I think about my own high school experience, I don't remember myself being apathetic, but then I look at someone like Tanisha Cunningham and her high school experience, and I realize that I very much was. Tanisha is a three-sport athlete. She participates in Upward Bound. This year she did the CNA program. She's in National Honor Society. She's an amazing student. She volunteers her time, you know, coaching other kids. So she's just amazing. You know, watching her on the basketball court, the volleyball court, she's always smiling, always enthusiastic, a joy to watch, you know, lifting up her teammates. So I'm really going to miss her. I'm also going to miss Miss Watson, seeing her at your games. I hope there's another Cunningham coming to me soon. But congratulations. I wish you well at University of Hartford. And have a great summer.
Hi, Jonathan. Congratulations on receiving your award. I'm so proud of you and everything that you've accomplished over the years that I've known you. I remember our early morning geometry class and even the demo lesson that got me the job at Danbury High School, and just your really positive and determined attitude to everything that I've had you guys do, and I appreciate you bringing that positive and light energy to our classroom. It would not have been the same without you. I also remember the donuts that you brought to our class that morning and all of the smiles that we exchanged in the halls. And I just hope that you continue to shine your light beyond Danbury High School. And I cannot wait for you to come back and visit to tell me all of the things that you will accomplish, and I know you will accomplish after graduation. Again, congratulations on the award and on graduating, and I hope we keep in touch.
I promise to keep secret the fact that Anna wrote one of the model papers that I showed not just to my honors class, but to my other classes. But the statute of limitations is up on that. So thank you, Anna, for writing papers that were a pleasure to read, that helped inspire your fellow students and to strengthen their work. Thank you for your intellectual curiosity, your interest not just in literature and humanities, but in science as well. And thank you so much for being a centered and compassionate person who gives us deeper hope in these difficult times. Have a great summer and congratulations.
Hey Olivia, it's Mr. Harris. I wanted to take a moment to congratulate you on your graduation and on your scholarship. As we talked the other day, it's been an amazing 2 years being with you. You work so hard. You're always a pleasure to have in class. I'm going to miss your smile. I'm going to miss talking with you. And I am so happy for you going on to college to Rhode Island. And I know you're going to be a success in anything that you do. Please don't ever change who you are. Always be the sweet, wonderful person that's always showed up in my class. And thank you again for everything. You've been an amazing student and person to get to know. Thanks so much and best of luck. Bye-bye.
Dana, felicitaciones! You did it! You're graduating! And not only that, but now all of your hard work is finally going to get truly recognized. It has been such a joy having you in class or as a YPP over the last couple of years. I am so proud of you for everything you've done. You've always worked hard, given every assignment your all, you've tried your best, and you've cared about your classes. But beyond that, I'm proud of you because you are such a special person for how you always choose to be kind and welcoming to everyone around you. Both of these things, your grit, your determination, and your ability to always be kind are going to make you very successful. I'm so proud of you, and you will be really missed not only in my classroom, but in all of DHS. Wishing you the best for the bright future that I know lies ahead of you. Au revoir. Félicitations.
Sophia was a student in the AP Literature and Composition course that I taught this year. Sophia is one of those students who just gets it. When I gave her feedback, she acted on it right away, and her spectacular grade in the course showed it. She's also bright, conscientious, and hardworking. She has a quiet charm about her. She's a student who, when called upon, is a deep and critical thinker. I have to say that I learned so much more about Sophia during distance learning because it not only created space for students to learn in a new way, but also provided opportunities for teachers to develop creative ways to engage students. In a recent discussion board post, I learned that Sophia had spent a gap year in Denmark, where her mother grew up. She learned a new language and adapted to a new way of living. Sophia, through your personal statement discussion board post, I grew even more to admire your talents, strengths, and unique experiences. You mentioned in your statement that the experience taught you that you can thrive anywhere, and that certainly is true. You thrived in my class, you thrived at DHS, and I know you're going to continue to thrive and do amazing things in the future. Best of luck at Cornell University. I'm going to miss you.
Congratulations, Oriana. We are so proud of you. It was a pleasure getting to know you in forensics this year. You are a very talented artist and a very conscientious student. Best of luck at RIT next year, Ms. Shermer and Ms. Barry.
Adam was a student in the AP Literature and Composition course I taught last year. That year, I'm pretty certain half of the class consisted of cross-country and track and field runners, with Adam being one of them. Since I love running and was a track and field member in high school, we often discussed running regimens and recovery regimens, as well as how not to get lost on a run. I'm pretty certain that if you're a serious all-terrain runner, this has happened at least once in your running career. It has happened to me. Don't worry, Adam. Adam, you were such a pleasure to teach. You worked so hard that year and really pushed yourself in order to grow as an effective writer, critical reader, and complex thinker. I also have a detailed memory of a time when I gave out Macbeth books and asked the class to annotate the text on sticky notes. You always followed directions and did what I asked. I was so delighted that I even took a photo of what you had done. Here it is. Look at all those sticky notes. I'm not sure how you were able to turn all those pages, but all jokes aside, not only did you annotate and closely read the text, but you showed me how serious you were about working hard and trying your best. I am so proud of you and will miss you. Best of luck at the University at Buffalo. Keep working hard and keep running.
I'm so excited to introduce Valerie Fox. Valerie ran varsity cross country for 4 years, and in that time, she was a part of a state championship team, a runner-up team, and a three-time New England qualifying team. Not only could I depend on her as a runner, but as a teammate. She showed how determination can get you through tough days and how to care for others around you on the good days. She truly cared for her teammates and will be missed. Valerie will be studying at my alma mater, Springfield College. I hope you enjoy your experience there as much as I did, both in the classroom and on the track. Running reminds us that even in our weakest moments, we are strong. Good luck, keep moving forward, and congratulations.
Congratulations, Alona Fury, on getting this academic golf scholarship. You've been a great student and athlete over the last 4 years, playing on the golf team for 4 years. You've had ups and downs, but you never gave up and you never quit. I wish you much luck and success, and keep playing golf and keep working hard in the classroom.
Hey, Christian, it's Mr. Leahy. Congratulations on winning your award. It's much deserved. I commend you for all your hard work with the Hatters Herald this year, especially covering the football team. You really did a nice job and helped bring their season to life. I hope you enjoy your summer, and I wish you nothing but future success at Hofstra. Keep working hard, and I know you'll find success and reach all of your goals. Go Hatters!
Dave again, you rock Calculus BC and the mic. That's why we call you MCBC or MBC squared. Not everybody can handle the highest math class you can take in high school, but you did it with your own unique style and flavor, bringing the juice every time. You're an amazing person, David, and the future for you is nothing but brilliance.
Hi, Ashley. I just wanted to take the time to say congratulations on everything that you've accomplished during your time at DHS. I feel very lucky to have been your teacher during your sophomore year. Your wit, your sense of humor, and your contributions to our class discussions were an integral part of our class dynamic, and I know that you're going to be successful in all of your future endeavors. I wish you the best of luck, and I look forward to hearing about all of your accomplishments. Congratulations, Ashley.
Hi, so Jess, I wanted to send a congratulations to you for your graduation of high school. Want to wish you the best of luck when you're competing and going to school at Eastern Connecticut. I remember you've always been about the team, and that team first mentality, you've kind of lived that out really well. So I'm really thankful for the last 4 years getting to know you as a student as well as a student athlete, and getting to know your incredible style. You've always had the most unique t-shirts. So I hope that you carry on that trend into the next step in your journey through life. So congratulations, Jess. Onward to the next thing.
Mia, when you walked into my room junior year, your friends had already told me you were coming. They had told me I was going to love having you as a student and that you were excited to meet me, but the pleasure was really all mine. You are such a wonderful young lady, and Springfield is so lucky to have you. Throughout the past 2 years, you've accomplished so much, volunteering with Ben's Bells and many other organizations, organizing the Safe Walk, participating in 2 varsity sports teams, being a part of peer leadership and completing your community change project, and the list can probably go on. I am so proud of who you are and who you're going to be in the future. Good luck in college. I'm going to miss you. Please don't forget to come back and visit. Congratulations.
Dad.
What?
Dad, we're making a video for Ricardo, remember?
We're making a recording for Ricardo. Ricardo Guadalupe! Hey! You're graduating! Such as it is. Hey, Ricardo, I am so glad that you blessed us with your presence for 3 years and took J-Team to heights I couldn't even imagine. You guys got the WPI, did a very, very excellent job, and hopefully you always remember that as the high point of this year. Excellent job for 3 years, Ricardo. You're such a calming presence to your team. When everyone's getting a little high strung, you bring everyone down, and your calmness and your moving forward is to be appreciated, and your team was lucky to have you. Good luck next year, wherever you find yourself, and some of the things that you've learned in A207, hopefully you'll bring them with you. Remember, a tinkerer tinkers and a mechanic does mechanical things. Always try to do it yourself before you call somebody.
Hi, Matt. Congratulations on your award. I am so happy for you. You were probably one of my favorite study hall students ever, and not a bad geometry student either. It's great that you got into Rochester Institute of Technology, and I know you'll do well. You were always the life of the party, I mean class, and hopefully you continue that at Rochester and make a lot of friends. Good luck in your chemistry, major.
Anastasia, you have been an asset to my classroom throughout the years. Your creativity and passion for learning is going to take you to levels far beyond. I am blessed to have been able to be a part of your life. You are creative, compassionate, driven, and innovative. You have a phenomenal ability to problem solve, work amazingly with your peers, and have the capacity to connect with everyone around you. We'll miss those pizza parties. You will create and do amazing things in your future. I have no doubt, that you deserve every accolade you receive. Congratulations, Anastasia, and don't forget your small-time art teachers. Love, Mrs. Noon. Kayla, no teacher could even dream up of how amazing of a student you've been. You are dedicated, ambitious, driven, and one of the most creative students I have seen. You are one of the few students in my AP's teaching that have actually completed all your required assignments on time. Your kind nature and ability to take critical information and apply it to your artwork has undoubtedly been the driving force for your success. You dedicated yourself to not only your own artwork, but artwork that helped inspire through your volunteer efforts. You will no doubt be changing the world. I will forever be referring to all your accomplishments through my future as a teacher. Please do not forget your art teachers as you become famous. You deserve every reward you receive. You will be missed greatly, Kayla. Love, Mrs. Noon.
Congratulations, Malachi. It has been a pleasure to witness you evolve into a well-rounded adult. I'm confident you will do well at Southern Connecticut State University. Remember, reading is the key to empowerment, and all you ever will need is already inside you. As Mother Teresa once said, and I quote, "If you are humble, nothing will touch you, neither praise nor disgrace, because you already know what you are." I cannot wait to hear about your successes. Congratulations.
Hello, my lovely Linda. I am so very excited for your future of possibilities. How very blessed I have been to have you in my Breakfast Club Flex and as my wonderful YPP this year. You are certainly one of the kindest, nicest, most helpful people I've ever known. Or helpful person, I should say, I've ever known. Your future is really bright indeed. Congratulations. Please keep in touch as I definitely want to know, hear all about your accomplishments and all the milestones in your life. Congratulations. I'm really proud of you.
Although I only had Leia for 1 year in AP French, she is one of the most memorable students that I've ever had. You can tell in everything that she does that she is just a good person. Of course, she is incredibly gifted and talented in academics, but also as a teammate, as a classmate, and as a friend to her fellow students. I have a lot of great memories of playing language games and just having a great time, and she has this infectious laugh that just makes you need to laugh along with her. And I know that these abilities will serve her well later in life. So, Leia, I wish you all the best. I know you're going to go on to achieve great things, and that you will contribute to every group that you are a part of in a positive way. I want to leave you with one of my favorite quotes. A cœur vaillant, rien d'impossible.
Hi, Sarah. It's been a while since I saw you in my Honors World Studies class, but I will never forget how passionate you were and what an incredible work ethic you have. Keep working hard and stay passionate because it'll bring you to great places in your life. Once a Hatter, always a Hatter, and once Team 6, always Team 6. So if you ever need anything, you know where to turn. You're going great places, kiddo, and I can't wait to see where you wind up. Congratulations.
Well, Angela Joseph. Angela Joseph is a remarkable young lady on many different levels. The most obvious is her work habits, her conscientiousness, and her innate intelligence. A very, very bright person. And the one thing that stands out is her focus. She is as intently focused a person as anybody I've ever seen in class. She was sitting in the back, and still, no matter what I did, however many digressions I got into, she was focused on what was going on. When I read her notes, they were impeccable. Did I actually say that? I really sometimes didn't even know to put down things that I said. But again, focused, very, very focused. But that's the one thing that is very obvious. Something else is very obvious is that she is shy and reserved. Does not speak much. Very, very quiet young lady. And of course, being the jerk that I sometimes can be, and those of you who know me know that that can be the case. One of my challenges was to get Angeli to speak. And so I'd go out of my way to try to get her to say something. Occasionally I was successful. More often than not, I was not successful. Another area where I was trying to gain some success with Angeli was in getting her to smile. Now, she's a good person, a happy person, but she doesn't smile much. It's just who she is. And of course, well, one of my objectives was to get her to smile. And so I would say some things that were so outrageously stupid occasionally that she couldn't help but smile. And when she did that, it tended to make my day, and I think helped make her day as well. She is very special. She's a remarkable young lady. And as time goes on, she is going to do very, very well in the world. I can see her being a doctor, a researcher, something that will allow her to use her magnificent intelligence. So good luck, Angeli, and it was a pleasure having you in class last year.
Imagine there's no homework and no assignments due. Well, Bradley, you don't have to imagine it because you're there. And I can only imagine what you're going to do in the future is going to be brilliant and amazing and beneficial to everyone in the world. So just remember that it's your move. And make sure you think three moves ahead and make the best move on the board.
Hey, Maria, congratulations on your award. I am so proud of you.
You have accomplished so much and you've worked so hard. I'm so happy that I've gotten to see you mature into the wonderful young lady that you are today. Such a hard worker, so kind. You are just going to do great things in the future. I just know it. I can't wait to hear all about them. Thank you for keeping me company during lunch this year. We had a lot of fun. We had a lot of great therapy sessions. It was really nice hanging out with you and the rest of the girls. I'm so proud of you. Congratulations on everything. You are so deserving of this award. And congratulations on graduation. You did it, girl. Bye.
Hi. So just to say a few words about Mei Li. I've worked with Mei Li for each year in track and field since her freshman year and really even in eighth grade during middle school when I helped out coaching with the middle school program. Really, Mei Li, you've been by far, in my mind, the best horizontal jumper in Danbury High School history. But it's not necessarily what you do, it's how you do it. You've done everything with diligence, intensity, intelligence, and a genuine care for the other girls on the team. I think that you've been a wonderful leader, a wonderful person, and I know that you're going to continue those tremendous traits in your future. I wish you all the best that the world has to offer you.
Hi, Sangeeta. Congratulations. You should be so proud of all of your accomplishments. I just wanted to take a minute not only to congratulate you, but to thank you for all of your hard work for Leo Club this year. We really couldn't have done anything without you. And I know our work got cut a little short, but you've made such an important contribution to your community through organizing all of those community service projects. I know that you're going to do such wonderful things in your future. And Danbury High School has been so lucky to have you for the last 4 years. And for me, it's been an honor to work with you. So best of luck and congratulations again. Bye.
Hey, Luke. Congrats on all of your success here at DHS. I was so lucky to have you as part of my classroom, even if that meant you and your friends were trying to convince others that I was a witch. I cannot wait to see how far you'll go beyond the walls of DHS. So, from one former drum major to another, congratulations and good luck.
Jackson, bye all. Congratulations on your achievement, winning the award. This is a memory time with your irreplaceable memories. I have an honor to have you for 2 years in Algebra 2 and AP Calculus BC. I remember one day I wear a Boy Scout pen with a Boy Scout belt, a uniform that I used to be assistant scoutmaster, and you asking me, if I was a Boy Scout leader. And after exchanging with you, I am so happy. I was so happy to learn that you are also an Eagle Scout. What a great accomplishment and dedication. That Boy Scout spirit has been shown throughout your tremendous effort in AP Calculus BC. As we currently live in a difficult and painful times, I hope we will remember this high school, Danbury High School, the place where your dreams is unlimited, the place where you are equal, respected, and shining. Jackson, congratulations on your coming graduation and good luck in college. Thank you.
You know what? Congratulations, Reed Lyle. And I mean that. Congratulations. You deserve everything you get. You are a consummate responsible, mature young man. I have not known you that long. I haven't seen enough of you this year. But I've seen enough kids to know when there's a good kid in front of me, when there's a kid that deserves what he wants out of life. And you, my friend, deserve what you want. You are just a nice kid to be around. You make other people feel good. I mean, you know, I could joke with you in class. We could be serious in class. We could joke about your brother in class. We could joke about a few other kids in class. You're fantastic, and I hope you get everything you want. This is the beginning of the real piece of your life that really, really, really is going to set you up well, and I'm so excited for you, and I just want to wish you the very best. So good luck and congratulations. I'm rooting for you, kid.
Daisy Mehta, congratulations on your winning the award. I have an honor to be your teacher, not just 2 years in Algebra 2 and AP Calculus classes, but on 4 years in the Upward Bound program at Westcon. Throughout these 4 years, I have watched you grow, mature, and overcome many challenges in life. I remember when you were in 10th grade, your curiosity in learning have made me amazed. You ask many questions during and after class, one after the other, until you completely understood and satisfied. This motivation and this good habits will help you tremendously in college. Congratulations on your coming graduation and good luck in college. And don't forget to visit your teacher next year during the break. Thank you.
Hi, Chantel. It's Miss Perez, obviously. I just wanted to make this video and say congratulations on your graduation. I am so proud to have taught you this past year in modern world history. You know, I know it's hard being a senior and mostly a sophomore class, but you really did well with it. And you really helped others, which it was so cool to see that kindness and compassion. Like, the world needs so much more of that. And, you know, you always pushed yourself to really do the best that you could. And when you didn't have a 99, you would get mad and, you know, wonder what you could do better. And, you know, that type of attitude is just, I mean, it's so cool to see someone that pushed themselves so hard. And I'm just so proud of you, and good luck in the Air Force. I wish you all but the best, and I hope that you keep in touch. And again, congratulations on everything that you've done.
I remember Aaron's freshman year here at Danbury High School and walking into class, you know, big bright eyes, positive attitude. He was a welcome addition to class. Aaron's a young man who loves God, his family, and his country. You know, he's really well-rounded. He's a strong athlete, supportive friend, sticks to his academics. A wonderful inspiration for all of us. I particularly remember his kindness to a student who others had treated a little cruelly at times, you know, outside of class. And Aaron was always so wonderful in making sure that everybody felt heard, including that person. So, I mean, Aaron, congratulations. You absolutely deserve this award. And I think we can all learn something from you in the way of compassion and kindness in the world today. So, congrats.
Kyla Mendez. The word that comes to mind when I think of Kyla is tenacious. I think that's the best word to describe her, because she's very determined and she does not give up easily. She works hard and long to achieve her objectives, no matter how much She likes the subject or doesn't like the subject. I was lucky enough to have Kyla for 2 years at Danbury High School. I had her last year as a junior for pre-calc. She was always prepared. She always did well. She was first to ask questions or make corrections and enjoyed her time in math class. She was really happy at the end of last year as she knew her more challenging math classes were coming to an end. She was not going to take calculus. She was going to sign up for AP statistics. And she was, as far as she was concerned, she was done with math. Well, lo and behold, when I checked my class list in August, guess who's on my AP calculus class list? Kyla Mendez. I was surprised to see her name, but it was suggested that she take calculus instead of AP stats, as it would look better for her intended college major. Kyla was not happy. I heard a lot of complaints over the year about how I'm not supposed to be in this class and I didn't want to be here and how hard it was, but she still managed to do extremely well. And even though she fought it every step of the way, I think she learned a lot and enjoyed herself. I really appreciate Kyla's directness and honesty. She's one of those people that wears her heart on her sleeve and is not afraid to show her opinion. These are admirable qualities, and I think those will suit her well as she pursues her career as a physical therapist. I want to wish Kyla the best of luck on her very long journey ahead. 6 more years of school, Kyla. I think she'll do great, no matter where she takes herself and what job she ends up in. She needs to believe in herself, and she can even do math that she doesn't want to do as long as she keeps continuing to put forth her best effort and try as hard as she can. Kyla, I want to wish you the best of luck. I know you'll be successful, and please keep in touch over the years.
Hi, Joe. Congratulations on getting awards and scholarships. You definitely deserve it. You worked so hard over the past few years, on top of clubs and sports and always getting hurt. You kept up your grades, you worked hard, and you really made the class a brighter place. You were always smiling, laughing, cracking jokes. You and your friend group had a fantastic time, and that made my class so much better. And it was a pleasure to have you there. And I can't wait to see what you do in the future. I know that you will be successful and work hard, and I wish you the best of luck. Again, congratulations, and I hope you keep in touch.
Hey, Jen, I remember you sitting in my room applying for this scholarship, and I just knew that your hard work and dedication was going to pay off, and I'm so glad that it did. Congratulations on this award. You were very, very deserving of this. You always worked really, really hard, and you always were able to manage all of your responsibilities, and you did it so gracefully and so well, and I know that that's something you'll continue to do. Thank you for coming by and visiting. I really enjoyed all of the visits and all of the updates on what you're doing. I know you're going to do great things at Delaware, and I can't wait to hear about them. With all of that said, congratulations not only on just this award, but on graduation. This is a big milestone, and I'm really proud of you. If you ever need anything, I am just an email click away. Bye.
Hello, Nilla. Talking to you from the comfort of my couch after a competition or a vacation, we've often said, well, what are we going to do over the break, or what are we going to do over on the Sunday? And I've always said, I want to hold down the couch with my dog. So here is the couch, and here is the dog I've been talking about for so many years.
Hey, Nilla. Just interrupting so I could say hi.
Nilla, I would like to thank you for 3 years of outstanding leadership and shepherding the younger kids and bringing them along and making sure that the entire team for the programming side was set to go on any given Saturday. I'm so excited that you are heading off to Cornell. Oh my God. And then when you get there, which you're gonna get there, everything that you have learned over the past couple of years, you will apply to all of your studies and all the things that you are going to see once you get there. Thank you, bottom of my heart, for these 3 years. You were fantastic. We'll see you soon.
When I saw your name on the scholarship list, I was like, oh my gosh, who better to get a scholarship? You're persistent, you're smart, you're funny. Any college would be so lucky to get you. So I tried to think of some funny way to make light of our situation. So I hope you enjoyed my karaoke, and I just want to congratulate you. You really were one of the good ones. I haven't had you in a year or so, and I loved that you still came to my flex. So you are gonna go out and save the world. Really, so over the moon for you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Salut, Danica. Felicitations. As one of the most dedicated students I have ever had, I cannot speak more to how worthy you are of receiving this award right now. I don't think I'll ever forget the time the entire class stopped and cheered you on while you tried to pronounce the word déménager. Though it was pretty funny and we all had a good laugh about it, including yourself, you're a great sport, it really spoke to how dedicated and determined you are and how unwilling you are to stop until you reach your best possible potential. I know that this is an attribute that will serve you so well in life and will make you very successful. Félicitations, congrats on graduating. You did it. Au revoir.
Dear Joao, I'm so happy to share in this excitement of your graduation and your awards. You can't imagine how proud I am of your accomplishments, and I know that this is just first of many proud and successful moments for you. And the other day I was just thinking about our class and class time together, and how anytime there was a difficult question that the whole class couldn't answer, you would be the one to save the whole class from this awkward silence and respond in such an clever and deep way that your whole class would be proud of you and your whole group would be proud of you. Please keep focusing on the most important things in life, and I know you will be successful at anything that you put your mind into. Good luck with everything.
Rashmi, you did it! Everything that you worked so hard for, congratulations, and you deserve everything you've gotten. But I'll tell you what, as proud as I am for all those accomplishments, I'll tell you what I'm really proud of. I am proud of the incredible, mature, caring, sensitive young lady that you are. I will never forget the way that you would include other people in the class and take over leadership roles in class in a very quiet way. And you didn't do it to hear yourself talk or to be able to have the floor, but rather you did it so that everyone's voice could be heard. And I think that this is truly the mark of great leadership, one that empowers other people to have a voice and then gives them a platform to use it. And you didn't think I was looking, did you? But I was watching. And this year, as you've come into my office every morning to say good morning, it's been a total pleasure for me to get to know you outside of the classroom and to see that the traits that I saw in the room weren't just show, they truly are who you are. I wish you all the best as you move forward into college and beyond. You're a little ray of bright, bright sunshine in a world that really needs people like you. I love you, Rashmi. Take care. Bye.
Hey, Tyler. Party. How are you? I've heard a secret. We've heard a secret. That you're about to get an award. And I'm very proud of you. He's very proud of you. You've come to the end of the road, graduating Danbury High School. We've all had a rough road. You've had a rough road. Many lessons have been learned. But now you're going to Florida State. You've been a great student and a great person. I've enjoyed spending time with you, getting to know you. Congratulations.
Hello, Jenny. Congratulations on this award and on your graduation. I know that you've worked hard for 4 years to get to this point, and I want you to remember that you were able to do that. You got through it, and it's going to get you to the next point in your medical career, whatever branch that may be. I think that those qualities, as well as your kindness, your thoughtfulness, are going to make you successful in whatever you choose to do. Thank you also for being such a terrific YPP in the library. I can't tell you how helpful it was to know that if I gave you a task, you'd get it done quickly and efficiently. And it was very much appreciated. We will miss you, but we're very happy for you. We wish you the best of luck. Take care.
Salut, Michelle. Félicitations. I'm so proud of you. You made it to graduation and you kept up those awesome grades that you've had all year. Not that I'm terribly surprised. You're so worthy of this award, and I'm so glad you got it because you really deserve it, and I hope you see that. You know, part of what makes you so special is not just those high grades that you get and you manage to have, you know, keep throughout your high school career, but on top of that, and maybe even more special than that, is your ability to really connect with everyone around you. It's actually pretty rare for high school kids to take the time out of their day to make that one-on-one connection with their teachers or their peers that maybe aren't their best friends. And I notice that for you, that's something that comes really naturally. I'm so proud of you. And I know that that ability to connect with everyone around you, combined with your natural intelligence and your grit and your drive, I know that you are going to be unstoppable. Felicitacion again and congratulations. Au revoir.
Hi, Jessica. Congratulations on your scholarship. I'm so proud to have been your teacher for the last 2 years, both in marketing class and with DECA. You did such a great job. When I sat down to think about all of the students that I've had, you stand out as the superstar. You have a great work ethic, and you get the job done. You care about your friends, and you're always thanking your teachers. I know your future is full of exciting experiences. I'm so glad that we've met, and I hope that soon we get to meet again. Jessica, I miss you. I miss all of the marketing students. Good luck in the future.
Hi, Nandika. Mrs. Williams here. I know I never officially had you as my student at DHS, but I feel like we really got to know each other during your time there. And I really wanted to take this opportunity to congratulate you since we never got to say goodbye. You are such an amazing girl. Even though you were never officially in my ESL class, you came and helped me with odd jobs in the classroom. and you help the students with their papers. And I just was so impressed by you. So I put this little presentation together. So the four things that come to mind when I think of Nandika are: you are kind, you are talented, you are confident, and you spread joy. I was so impressed by your ability to dance in front of hundreds of people at International Night. You work together with those girls and your dance troupe so well, and you were really good at resolving any issues that came up along the way. And man, you are such a talented dancer. I couldn't believe my eyes. And you know, you are a talented student. You just crushed that whole nursing program, got great grades, and you did it all with such a positive, happy attitude that was just contagious. You walk into the room with that bright smile of yours and people just feel good. You brighten their days. So congratulations are in order. You did such a wonderful job here at DHS, and I know you're going to do great things in school and in your career. Don't forget what we see in you. Even when times get tough, I have a feeling you're always going to be that bright, talented, hardworking girl that we all know and love. Take care, and don't forget my email. Stay in touch. Keep me posted.
Hi, Jess. Congratulations with graduation and all your awards. I am just truly happy for you, truly excited for you. I know this is only the beginning for you. You have all the combination of success. You are a caring person, intelligent, just the nicest, kindest person I know. And it has been an honor to have known you this throughout the year. And you do everything to your best ability, and I know that you will be successful at anything you put yourself, you know, you put your mind into. Please keep being this kind and caring and awesome human being. Good luck. Love you.
Congrats.
Mega started off the year strong, and she continued to show time and again that she was committed to doing really well in AP chemistry. She often would come in with her work done ahead of time so that she could check her answers, go through anything that she was in need of assistance on, and just pushed and pushed and pushed to be as successful as she possibly could in a very, very challenging class. Meanwhile, on the surface, she was calm, she was collected, she never appeared to be frazzled by any of the work that was going on in my or any other classes. So she appeared to her peers like this was a breeze for her and she didn't have to work very hard. But I know that behind the scenes, there were countless hours spent working to understand the material. And that type of work ethic is going to ensure your success in the future, Mega.
Hi, Diana. Congratulations on your award. You have always been a really serious and determined young woman. I first realized this when you qualified for nationals last year for HOSA and organized amazing bake sales and sought out gift cards and donations so the trip could become a reality. And here you are, Splash Mountain, enjoying that trip and your successes at nationals. Also, I thought it was pretty awesome how, as we went to distance learning, you came up with the most creative and fun ways to continue to practice your skills so that you could realize your dream of becoming a CNA so that you could go on to college and study healthcare. Here you are using a cute little teddy bear as your patient to show how to stop bleeding in the case of a trauma. And here you are over here creating a catheter bag out of a Ziploc baggie, some tape, in a little straw and making a wonderful demonstration. So your tenacity and your hard work will carry you through college, and you will do well with whatever path you choose. Congratulations.
Alex Soliski, congratulations on this award. I've known you since your freshman year when you were in my advisory class, and you'd be getting into all my physics apparatus trying to figure out the way that the world works. And then we had each other last year together in AP Physics, and that sense of curiosity and inquiry about the world around you just kind of continued and deepened. And I know that's going to serve you well as you continue your studies at Norwich University. So once again, congratulations and best of luck for the future.
Congratulations, Carolina. You and I have been together for each of the past 4 years as you were either a student or YPP in different science classes, and I appreciate you so much. You have shown that you are a natural learner in the way that you understand concepts and connect them. You remain dedicated, responsible, and organized, and you don't give up when things are challenging. These are some of the highest academic compliments I can give, yet these don't even begin to describe my favorite things about you. You're such a kind and caring classmate to your peers. Your transcripts will never show how many students you have helped to feel more comfortable and be more successful at Danbury High School. I have witnessed you time and time again acting as an unofficial ambassador for DHS as you welcome anxious new students and give them support, guidance, and unconditional friendship. You have made such a difference in so many lives through these acts of kindness. These were not things that anyone had asked you to do, but you did them because that is the wonderful person you are. I'm thankful to you because I see the difference that you have made at the school that we love. In my mind, you are the portrait of a Danbury High School graduate. I am so excited to see what you do next, as I am confident that you will continue to make us proud. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Carolina Sinango. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Christine, on winning these awards and scholarships, and congratulations on graduating from high school. It wasn't the way we thought it was going to end, but we got through it, and we stuck together, and I just want to thank you for a wonderful year. It was wonderful getting to know you and reading your writings and hearing your insights and discussions, and you know, watching as you went through the college search and tried to figure things out, and as you navigated the sports seasons and everything like that. I wish the year ended better for you and for all of your peers, but you know, having gotten to know you this year, I know you know the world is your oyster, and you're going to be able to achieve all of your goals. So I wish you the best of luck, and I hope everything goes just as I planned it would for you. Bye.
Hi, Yasmin. I just wanted to say congratulations on receiving this award and on graduation. Both are well-deserved, and I am so proud of everything that you've accomplished. I just remember the hardworking, positive attitude and the willingness to help others that you brought to our class, and I just want to thank you for everything that you brought that made our classroom environment so successful and positive. I still have that Pythagorean spiral ram that you made. It's one of my favorite pieces of my classroom art that I will forever cherish. Best of luck to you. Again, I'm so proud of you. The field of criminology is going to be so lucky to have someone like you in their career. And I cannot wait for you to come back and visit to tell me all the things that I know you will accomplish. Best of luck.
Oh, well, I never was there ever. A student so clever as Serenity Schreiber.
Serenity, you wrote your final paper for AP Lang on cats, so I thought it was only appropriate to open with that jam. You're welcome. Serenity's sense of humor, as well as her insights and willingness to contribute during discussions, was fantastic during AP Lang this year. I really enjoyed getting to know you, Serenity. And I also was very proud of you when I saw just in the paper the other day that you were one of the people that was instrumental in organizing the protests this week in Danbury. So I'm proud of you for using your skills and privileges to amplify the voices of those around you. So congratulations. I wish you only the best in the future. And I know that you'll be fantastic. That's all I got.
Hi, Shomo. I just wanted to congratulate you on this senior award and to say how much I enjoyed getting to know you this year, working with you this year. It's been a joy. You're a fine young man, and I really enjoyed our give and take. I remember when I introduced myself to you in your class, and I mentioned that in my that I had a former career as a newspaper man, and your eyes lit up and your hand went up. And I felt like I was a source, and you were a reporter because you were peppering me with questions about that job of mine. And I loved it. And I knew right then and there, this kid's got an inquiring mind, and we were going to get along famously. And I think we did. I really do appreciate your work ethic, your sense of humor, your inquiring mind, your intellectual curiosity, very much appreciate. And I just want to wish you all the best, and take good care, Shomo. Take care. Bye-bye.
Hi, Bree. Congratulations on your graduation and your awards. I am so excited for you. We all made it. We finally made it. I just wanted to wish you good luck at Westchester College and anything that else you're going to plan in the near future. I think you're going to be a great social worker. You are an outspoken, strong person. With very, very caring heart. And I just wanted to wish you best of luck at anything you do. Focus on the most important things and enjoy your time with your family and friends. Again, I'm going to miss you a lot. Congratulations.
Laura, I'm so excited that you're graduating. I remember when you first came into my classroom freshman year, surrounded by juniors and seniors in creative writing, and there you were holding your own. And I can assure you, they were surprised when they saw some of the creative writing and videos that you put together, such as this. Now, Laura did love writing thrillers and horror, and she always has had a wonderful sardonic wit that I have always appreciated, but she's also always been driven with her academics and a great worker with her friends and with her classmates. So I wish you only the best, Laura, as you move on to UMass Amherst. I'm looking forward to all of your sardonic humor in the future. Take care. Good luck.
Hi, Amish. I wanted to extend my congratulations to you on graduation and winning this award. I think if I could use one word to describe you, it would be kind. I remember last year, all the moments of glory that you would share in class, really just showed what a kind and caring person you are. And I'm really glad I got to know you over the last year and that we got to share that learning space together. You're passionate about learning. I know it's going to serve you well in the future. I'm really excited that you have for all that you have in front of you. And again, congratulations. Be well.
Alton Spencer is the coolest kid I've ever met. His ability to discover exoplanets before graduating high school is truly remarkable. I remember in creative writing class, he would try to tell me everything he has been studying recently, and I would listen intently, trying to understand half of what he was trying to explain to me, and I didn't have a clue. But I do remember the way his classmates looked at him as he would talk about these things, and they were blown away. It was almost as if they couldn't believe the extent of his intelligence and the extent of his accomplishments. And for one of his final assignments for creative writing, he had to write a children's book. And of course, he wrote about exoplanets and planets in the solar system, and he illustrated it beautifully and did just a fantastic job. And I read all those books, including Alton's, to my son, and I wanted to share that with you now.
Let's go on a trip to outer space. We'll take this rocket ship to the planets, their moons, and beyond. Climb aboard. 3, 2, 1. Blast off!
Thank you, Alton, for such a great memory and for being a kid who I know will go the distance.
Couldn't wait for Mr. Donovan to send through the senior awards sheet because I knew that your name was going to be on it and I wanted to do your video. I have to tell you that having you as a student last year made my entire year. You're just such a conscientious student. You're kind, you're caring. You wanted to get better. And that's something that as a teacher, it means a lot. I know that we worked really hard on your writing last year, and I have absolutely no doubts that when you go to college in a few months, whether it's online or in person, you're going to kick some serious butt. I will miss you because you will be in Florida, but when you come home to visit, make sure you let me know so we can catch up, and I can't wait to see all of the wonderful things that are going to happen for you in the future. Bye.
Emma Sullivan. Emma Sullivan's, the first words that come to mind when you think of Emma Sullivan are friendly and likable. She has a type of personality that lights up the room whenever she walks in it. I cannot recall her being in a bad mood, really, throughout the whole time that I've known her, which is all last year, and in the hallways this year. I can't remember her ever being in bad spirits. She always has a bright smile on her face. And the one thing that gets me most about Emma Sullivan is that she has an enthusiasm for life. And that enthusiasm can be clearly seen in her eyes. And anybody who knows her, I think, can't help but really like her. As a student, Emma is another great example of someone who has great work ethic, is conscientious, and is going to be determined to get whatever she wants in life through hard work and effort. There were times in AP US last year where she struggled in some areas, and she asked for help, and we worked on things, and she worked harder, and she got it. You know, so sometimes all you need is a little nudge. Gave her a couple of nudges, and she was on her way. To give you an idea of what kind of a person she is as well, and how she cares about other people, and is so enthusiastic. Last spring, I told my classes that my granddaughter was going to be named Emma. My granddaughter, who was born in August, was going to be named Emma. Not after Emma Sullivan. My son and Emma don't know each other. But when I said that, it put a big smile on Emma Sullivan's face. That's the kind of person that she is. She takes those little types of things and takes great pleasure out of that. As time goes on, she is going to be a very successful young lady in many ways, mostly because she has an enthusiasm for life and she has the ability to attract people to her. And she will add to that her conscientiousness and hard work. Emma Sullivan has a great, great future ahead of her.
Congratulations, Faith, on completing high school and graduating, and on all the awards and scholarships that you've won today, and congratulations on graduating valedictorian. I know you worked really hard this year at it, and it was really a pleasure getting to know you this year. Your writings and your insights and your analysis were just, such a pleasure to read. And, I really appreciated being able to use your work as student examples, and really appreciated all of the things that you brought to the class every day when we met. I know you have the work ethic and you have the skills and you have the talent to be able to achieve all of your goals and dreams. And I'm excited to see where that's going to take you. So I just want to say congratulations again, and I hope all of your dreams come true and you reach all of your goals. And congratulations.
Jordan, there are no words to tell you what a joy it is, what an honor, what a gift it is to be your teacher, your director, your friend. It is incredible to have watched you tell such important stories on stage, from singing about love last year to your role in the Laramie Project, or multiple roles, to bringing people together in strength and unity as Jack Kelly, to your role in Anonymous, telling the important and difficult stories. I know your time was cut short, but the world is your stage, and you will continue with your heart and your passion to tell those important stories and bring people together. There is no one more deserving of this theater award than you are. And with all my heart, I just need to express to you what incredible gift it is to have shared this time together. I wish you all the best, and I know we will stay in touch. You are a treasure.
Hi, Caitlin. Congratulations. I'm so excited for you as you prepare to go and get ready for your journey at UConn. I'm sure it'll be exciting starting something new. Just kind of keep in mind all the stuff that you've gained over your time at DHS. I know that I've gotten just to know a lot about you by, listening to you chat about stuff in Flex or your interactions or just emails. I'm really excited that I got to kind of share some different things with you. I know that we worked on an invisible diversity piece, and you had kind of expressed, all these people have something that's like very significant that's happened in their life, and I don't feel like I've really like found what that is yet. And I hope college and different experiences moving forward really brings that for you. I know it's been fun getting to know about like your sense of humor, talking about TV shows and different things, and you're such an observant student, and it's been great to see those different layers of you. Your passion for softball is amazing. I apologize for everything that's been happening, and wish that you could have gotten to experience that captainship senior year, but you're an amazing person, and I can't wait to see things that you do in the future. Hold tight to those dreams, and congratulations. Good luck at UConn.
Brian, you are kind, compassionate, funny, and hardworking, and together these traits are going to take you far in life. I was fortunate enough to have you as a student not only your freshman year, but your senior year, so I was able to see how much you grew. We had a conversation at the beginning of the year, and we talked about how cool it would be if we shaved our heads and how cool it would look. And you mean a lot to me, so I held up my end of the bargain. I don't know if you have. I'm really looking forward to seeing what you do in your next chapter. Thanks for all the great memories, and congratulations on your award.
Ayeli, I want to congratulate you in a special way for this award, for all you have accomplished this year in Ohio School, for all the effort you have made, and for having reached your goal. Follow your path with the certainty that I have great success coming for you in the near future. Mayeli, it has been my pleasure to meet you and have you all these years in Latino Club. You were secretary officer twice. Outstanding, Mia. Your efforts and hard work these years mean you have now your high school diploma. And all you have achieved is a vista for great things coming in your future. I wish you the best in whatever profession you have chosen to study. Congratulations, Mia. And good luck in all your projects. Con mucho aprecio, Mr. Rojas.
Allison Vecchia Spooner. Who would have thought 2 years ago that I would be blessed with the ability to, in a very small sense, send you off? As I recall, everything was not exactly peaches and herb, if I may say that, last year. In fact, there were lots of times when you did not appreciate something that I might have assigned, or, you know, the beauty of being Allison Vecchia Spooner, as Mr. Porcelli sees it, is that you knew most of the time how to react to that, you know, how to say, hey, I don't really agree with you right now. And that's cool. That's not only your right, well, it will be your right when you become a real, you know, adult human being. But it's what we all should do, right? We should all be free to voice our discontent in a mostly responsible and respectful way. And you did it. And you were great. And you know that I think you're great, and you know that I'm going to miss you. And you have to know that I think you're just a fantastic kid who has such a bright future ahead. Congratulations on the awards that you're winning tonight. Congratulations on your graduation, and good luck.
Hi, Joy. Just wanted to tell you how very proud I am of you. I've had you for the last few years at Danbury High School, and I've seen you grow from a quiet, quiet, shy girl to a not so quiet, shy girl, but still quiet. And it was an absolute pleasure having you in Spanish class, and I've also seen you grow as a Spanish student, and it's been really wonderful to watch you. I hope you take the world by storm, because it is meant for you to do. Congratulations, and I'll miss you at DHS.
Hello, Jocelyn, and congratulations. You have won yet another scholarship at Danbury High School. I just wanted to say congratulations and to be one of the first to say that you have made such a tremendous difference in the Air Force Junior ROTC unit here at Danbury High School. When the chief and I arrived this year, you were one of the first to help us get our feet settled and get us on the right path so that we could have a successful year, and that we could transition and have a successful unit long after you're here. You're going to have a strong legacy here at Danbury High School, and you're going to have a strong legacy wherever you go in the future. Congratulations, and I hope you all the best.
Hi, Tyler. I just want you to know I love being your teacher. In fact, you were awesome to have as a student. You have such a great combination of personal traits and intellectual gifts that are going to take you really far in life. So I'm honored to be able to stand here and say congratulations, and I wish you the best always. But I have to say, I'm going to miss passing you in the hallway and hearing hola, senora. So hola, Tyler, for the last time, and now it's time to say adios, Tyler. Que te vaya bien.
I'd like to congratulate Jack Watson on his remarkable 4 years at Danbury High School. I've had the privilege and pleasure of coaching Jack for 4 years, 12 seasons. Jack competed in cross country in the fall. He was captain of our fall cross country team this year and finished all state. He was also a member of the indoor track and field team during the winter. This year he was all New England, and he was also captain of that program and that team as well. And this spring for outdoor track and field, Jack was set up to have a remarkable season. He was also captain of the spring outdoor track and field team. Jack was a tremendous student as well as athlete. He was a remarkable teammate and friend to many on the cross country and track and field team, plus just during in the normal high school community. Jack was relentless in his work ethic, his attitude, and his leadership. I would like to congratulate Jack on this award, much deserving. As always, the future is bright for Jack. I am sure he's going to be going on to do very bright and successful things in the future at Quinnipiac, where he's going to be a Division I student athlete and competing for their cross country team. Again, Jack, congratulations. Thank you for so many special memories and experiences throughout your 4 years. I'll never forget you. And I know that you'll always be a Hatter, because once you're a Hatter, you're always a Hatter. Thank you.
Hello, Erica. Just wanted to say congratulations on your award. I know that it's well-deserved. Obviously, you're an amazing student. You've worked very hard to get where you are. Wanted to say thank you for, you know, always just being such a positive connection in the building for me. Being someone who I always loved hearing from, hearing updates about how life is going. And I really hope that these updates and these conversations don't end here. As always, feel free to reach out and keep this connection going. I know that you're going to be beyond successful in whatever endeavor you decide to apply yourself. And you know, I wanted to let you know that I've grown too in these 2 years. I've learned how to properly refrigerate frozen food items, because as you and I both know, the Great Cookie tragedy of 2019 is something that's really hard to forget. Cut down in their prime of life, this poor batch of cookies will never live to see their life fully actualized. And since I've learned the errors of my ways, and I now know that frozen cookies cannot stay in a school desk for longer than 5 hours without, you know, all turning into one big block of cookie. And then from there really isn't much that can be done. So it's really sad that I will not have you as my cookie plug from here on out. I don't know where I'm going to get them. It's a tragedy comparable to Hamlet, honestly. So thank you. It was a pleasure having you as a student, and let me know if you know anyone else who is in the cookie business. See you soon.